Good morning, student. Today we are going to continue with the chapter Parliamentary Form of Government. Previously we have read about what is Parliament, the nominal head and the real head of the executive, that is President and Prime Minister, their functions and powers we have read. Then we have read about the Council of Ministers. Now we are going to read about the two houses of parliament, that is the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha is also known as the House of People and Rajya Sabha is known as the Council of States. So today we are going to learn about both the houses of parliament, that is the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. Okay. So Lok Sabha is called the House of the People and it is the lower house of the parliament and is elected directly by the people on the basis of universal adult franchise. So it is the lower house of the parliament and directly elected by the people. Okay, so it is the lower house of the parliament and it is directly elected by the people on the basis of the universal adult franchise and secret ballot. The speaker is the presiding officer of the house of the Lok Sabha. A deputy speaker is elected who presides in the absence of the speaker. So the speaker is the presiding officer of the Lok Sabha. Speaker who presides the meeting of the Lok Sabha. Now we'll read about the composition of Lok Sabha. Composition of Lok Sabha. The Lok Sabha consists of 550 members. 550 members. Okay. Out of which 530 are elected from states while 20 are elected from union territories. Seats are allocated to each state on the basis of population. The president even nominated two Anglo-Indian members to Lok Sabha to give the community adequate representation. At present, Lok Sabha has 545 members. 545 members at present. Okay. At present, the Lok Sabha is having 545 members. Now we'll read about the qualification for becoming a member of the Lok Sabha. Qualification for becoming the member of the Lok Sabha. Okay. First qualification, he should be a citizen of India. He should not be less than 25 years of age. He should not hold office of profit under the government of India. He should not be bankrupt or of sound mind. So, first, he should be a citizen of India. He should not be less than 25 years of age. He should not hold office of profit under the government of India. He should not be bankrupt or of unsound mind. These are the qualifications needed to become the member of the Lok Sabha. Now, terms of the Lok Sabha. The Lok Sabha is elected for a term of 5 years. However, its tenure can be extended in case of an emergency. It can be dissolved even earlier in the tenure of the Lok Sabha ends and no party in a majority to form the government. So, the tenure of the Lok Sabha is 5 years. It can be extended also. Okay. Now we are going to read about the Rajya Sabha or the Council of State. It is the upper house of parliament and is elected indirectly by the MLAs of State Legislative Assembly on the basis of proportional representation. The Vice President is the presiding officer or chairman of the house and the members elected are deputy chairman who preside over in the absence of the chairman. Now we'll read about the composition of the Lok Sabha. Composition of the Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha consists of 250 members, out of whom 238 are elected from state and union territories, while 12 members are nominated by the president from among people who have distinguished themselves in the field of education, literature, science, technology, etc. Currently, there are 245 members. 245 members currently. Okay. Now, qualification for becoming a member of the Rajya Sabha. Qualification. He must be a citizen of India. He should not be less than 30 years of age. He must not hold any office of profit under the government of India or state. He must not be bankrupt or must not be of unsound mind. So these are the qualifications required to become a member of the Rajya Sabha. Now the tenure of office of the Rajya Sabha. Tenure. Okay. The Rajya Sabha is a permanent house which is never dissolved. Its members are elected for a term of 6 years and one third of its members retire after 2 years. 6 years is the tenure. Now we are going to read about the function of the parliament. Function of the parliament. Okay. Function of the parliament. First function is legislative powers. Legislative powers. It has exclusive power to make laws on subject mentioned under the union list and decidory powers. It makes laws on concurrent lease, and in case of a conflict with the state law, the central law prevails over the state law. It makes laws on state lease if Rajya Sabha passes a resolution or if two or more state legislature request for it. On ordinary bill, both the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha have equal powers, and in case of a deadlock, a joint sitting is held to pass the bill. Lok Sabha in such an eventuality enjoys numerical advantage over the Rajya Sabha because the strength of the Lok Sabha is more than the Rajya Sabha. Okay. Now the second power is of financial power. Financial power. First financial power exercised by the parliament is budget or money bills are presented only in the Lok Sabha. On money bill, Rajya Sabha enjoy only a delaying power of 14 days, after which the bill is sent to the president for his assent. If the budget or money bill initiated by the government is rejected in the Lok Sabha, the government has to resign. The budget is prepared in two parts. The railway budget is represented by the railway minister and the general budget, which is presented by the finance minister. Now the third power is control over the executive. Control over the executive. The parliament controls the executive in the following manners: by asking questions and supplementary questions in the 0 hour, by appointing joint parliamentary committees, by adjournment motion, by censure motion, by rejecting the budget or cut motion, by passing a vote of no confidence. The power of rejecting the budget or passing a vote of no confidence is the exclusive prerogative of the Lok Sabha, and it is the power which makes the Lok Sabha more powerful than the Rajya Sabha. Now the constitutional amendment powers. The fourth power is constitutional amendment power. Okay. So both the houses have equal power to amend the constitution, simple majority or by two-third majority of the parliament. Now electoral powers. Both the House of Parliament elect the President of India along with the Member of State Legislative Assembly. Both the House of the Parliament also elect the Vice President of India. The Lok Sabha elects the Speaker and the Deputy Speaker, while Rajya Sabha elects its Vice Chairman. judicial power, both the houses, the power to impeach the president, vice president, chief justice of India and judges of the Supreme Court and High Court, chief election commissioner of India and other person on constitutional bodies. Now, who are the people in the parliament? That means how the parliament works and who actually make the working. So democracy is a form of government which is truly representative. This is clearly evident in India, where every section has representatives in the parliament. The parliament has people from different backgrounds. Thus, there are more rural members and members from many regional parties. Groups which are not represented for long in the parliament now being elected. There has been an increase in political participation from the Dalit, backward castes and the minorities. A representative of democracy cannot produce a perfect reflection of a society if does not give historical marginalized section adequate representation. That's why from all the section of the society, everyone participation is needed. For this, seats for scheduled castes and scheduled tribes are reserved in the parliament. Likewise, it is suggested that women should also get 33% reservation in parliament. Rajya Sabha passed the bill on March 2010, but it is yet to be voted by the Lok Sabha. The bill is still pending, but it is likely to strengthen the democracy. So we have completed our chapter of parliamentary form of government. In the next class, we'll provide with you question answers through WhatsApp app. Thank you, new student. Goodbye.